It's too much.
So, where we left off... Stop staring at me like that.
You're the one talking.
Shut up. Last week... Oh, sorry, not last week. I don't know. I don't know when we've been meeting here recently. A while. Last session. You guys were going through your week. I didn't hear you, and I hope the recording didn't.
Okay, I didn't say anything bad.
Okay, I don't know. Anyway, so,
he said a naughty word.
Josh's existence is a naughty word.
Which one, though?
So last session.
Wait, did you start recording?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
This is a terrible start. Anyway,
penis.
Got him. Alright, go ahead.
Was that what you were waiting for, Josh? You didn't say
I wasn't waiting for anything. Just making it hard for him by not doing anything.
You are.
Well, you are waiting for
so at this me. Point, you wanted me to say something just so it'd be over.
The anticipation was pretty agonizing.
To our auditory listeners, aka everyone who isn't in this room right now, Nathan's turning red.
Oh, I am? Okay.
You were when you were laughing.
Nice. You guys had, it was after Agnar came by and basically gave his brother the ultimatum of, kill half of your, sacrifice half of your slaves, or...
Sacrifice for
Ulvert's dog will come and, kill all of them. Some of you were preparing for, that attack. Yep. By dabbing.
But always.
Eventually the time came. And the...
Stop staring at me, Josh. I hate you.
You're the one talking!
He's performing active listening. He deserves a gold star on his star chart. For active listening.
The tall... large, brutish man. Did you learn his name? Yeah, you did. Erikir.
Erikir.
I can't look at you right now, Josh. I don't know. I'm sorry.
No, you made him feel ashamed of himself. It's okay, Josh. Keep staring at
him. I always feel ashamed of myself. It's normal. Anyway, so he showed up with six other men. And upon his arrival... Vithir tried to talk to him, talk him down, and essentially threaten him at one point. But he would not have it, and he attacked. All of you begin to run, except for... Well, all of you Saxons who were taken from your homes recently began to run. And the others were staying behind, either not fighting because they were not able to do so, or... trying to hold them back while you guys escaped. You guys actually managed to run into the woods fairly unharmed. I'm pretty sure it was only NPCs, I think just like Drefin who took an injury.
I think
the most
that any of us took was health damage.
Yeah.
We were like, a couple of us were one health gain.
Yeah. So.
I didn't take any damage.
Only made it out, not made it out with only a few scratches and such.
I have a question, sir.
No.
Mm-hmm. Yeah?
Never mind.
What?
You need to raise your hand, Josh. Raise
well,
your
we
hand.
We ended with you guys making it into the forest and on the run.
Get fancy iced.
So, you all managed to get out of the eyesight and presumably earshot of any pursuers that you may have. You were running on a trail that was pre-made by Leo and Sophie. You then broke from that trail.
I hated trail.
Slow down a bit and we're moving quieter, more carefully, trying not to leave tracks and trying not to make much noise.
All I remember from last session is I did almost the worst possible stealth roll.
Yeah, it was pretty fine.
Oh right, and you were an important note. Does anyone remember or wrote down where it is that Fifth Theater told you to go?
I remember.
You do?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where?
It's farm.
You wrote it down. You even said you wrote it down.
There's a village to the, or a farm or whatever to the north. And it was like, I think the second house on the right. Second or third. I don't remember the names. I didn't understand.
I think I wrote down the names. It was, and I probably am saying them wrong, Talik and Toby. I wrote down the names. I didn't write down exactly where to go, but if you'd like, sir.
It's, he can roll it's, 20 dice. It's Talik and Toby. Toby.
Toby. Okay.
Toby.
The village was called Stenhus, and it's to the north.
Stenhus.
No, come on, man. So, I'm leaving in your guys' hands on how you would like to get there and what.
We're following.
You're currently deep in the woods.
Mm-hmm.
So, before we start going, did we, like, actually disable one of the people before we left?
Presumably, yeah, one of them was blinded and thoroughly screwed up, one of the archers.
Okay, so there was three archers that was following us.
Three archers, three melee, and then the Derekure.
Okay.
Oof.
Alright,
technically so, right until the end of combat.
Sorry. Yeah.
But he was also stabbed and shot up.
Yeah.
My other question is this, are we still considered in their counter, or can we heal our health damage?
You can, you haven't had time to rest at all, so for now your health damage stays.
Cool.
Rip, we get an injury.
Yeah,
we... You're gonna break both
of your. You guys are gonna have to take a moment to stop and breathe and relax. Well, not relax, but calm. But ease your body. Let it recover from those.
Hey, we're not taking that moment yet. We are still moving.
I mean, yeah. It's up to him.
Yeah, we're following you.
We're in your zone.
If you have any complaints, it sucks for you.
I have many complaints, but not
sucks about... for you.
Okay.
If he's at the back of the line, it doesn't matter. You can lodge your complaints to Sophie. She's with you.
Okay. Sophie's in the back making sure everyone is dying.
Ooh,
I'm not giving happens? You guys in. What are you doing? This is in your
we're
court.
Starting forward. What do you want me to roll?
You're just walking forward?
We're stealthily moving. Carefully.
Uh-huh.
South.
Moving south, yeah, definitely. No. No, we're going north.
Okay. First, then, roll me a survival orientation.
Did we get points last time?
Got 10 points.
10 points.
Did I use them?
I have no idea.
I don't think I did.
You should have written it down.
If you want, you can count your experience points, and if it leads up to 180, you have not used it.
I'm pretty sure when we ended, I was really tired 90. And stuff.
Yeah, and you said
well, I'm saying
time.
If you're
yeah,
at
and I already had an idea of what to put him in, so.
And you were in a hurry to go home.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, you probably didn't. After this roll, you can use him.
Well, I already know what I'm going to use it for. I'm going to count it for this roll, so whatever. It is 17. What? Can you see the book for exactly what I want to write down?
What is it?
The education thing, no.
Yeah, education.
Wow.
Okay, that's my, I rolled a 17.
Alright. And after that is a success. And then after that, roll me a stealth for,
everyone is rolling that, I assume?
Yeah, everyone's rolling me. Everyone roll me a stealth.
Hey, I'll take it. This is the first time I've ever rolled stealth.
That's not true.
And last time.
Yeah.
In this game, yes.
11.
Because I never got to roll stealth before.
True. You're like a 0.
Oh, yeah.
Oakgar was not allowed to stealth.
Alright, you got an 11?
Mm-hmm.
What'd you get? 5?
Hey.
What'd you get?
7.
Wow. And what'd you get, Max?
13.
Ooh.
So you used to say the most likely character we meet would be Samaria and Cess. We wouldn't meet Cess. It's too hard to see.
Seth has been watching you guys this whole time and you just never realized
it. He was under the boat with a straw.
Wait, we have a sight boy. Would the sight boy not see him?
No. He's too high level.
He's very high level.
You get like 40 stones.
If someone rolls really bad, but then you roll really good.
Then there's a chance.
Yeah, maybe.
I'm still not as good as me.
Alright. So, you guys as a group moving very carefully together. It is hard to stay stealthy in a group of 10 people.
But we do so anyways.
No. As you guys are moving along about probably 3 or so hours. Mm-hmm.
He didn't say like how far away it was.
No.
Cool.
You guys moving actually someone roll me a D6 real quick. Who's feeling lucky?
Oh god, 5 is the worst.
Oh wow.
It starts snowing.
Nope.
None of us
have
winter
stormy.
Here.
Oh, that's true.
It was storming.
It is still storming, yeah.
Because I wanted to play Thor and...
Yeah, which may or may not help cover up your tracks and stuff you leave. Who knows?
It's probably worse.
Probably made Will falling on his face a lot louder.
I don't remember falling on
that,
face.
Or if Matt...
You fell, and it just...
Because of the...
I had a bad stealth check. I don't remember falling.
No, you tripped, and Sophie had to help you up.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, anyway.
And then I went back and was like...
Yeah.
Yep, that's what it sounded like.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay. Shoot, what was I going to say?
I don't know.
I completely forgot.
We are...
Three hours.
There's a 5.
3 hours.
Right, that's what was going to happen.
Okay.
Bandits.
We rolled and there was a fight. No. I'll be incapacitated.
No.
Someone will have to drag me along. I'll just go stiff as a board and pick me up.
Okay, gorillas.
Barkley will kind of, he's probably, I think he was closer to the back of the line. He'll stop and then just like, hold up, wait, 1 second. I think, look, kind of glancing at some people in the group. I think it's time. Don't you?
I'm like dying of breathing.
Yeah, I'm trying to breathe.
It's time?
You know, Dreffen says, I don't know if now is the best time. Why? They're hunting us now. And this is too big of a group. It's better when there's less of us. They won't expect it now.
What are you guys talking about?
You guys can't go off when we've got people who are injured.
No one's really injured.
We've got NPCs that are injured.
Do we?
Yes.
Dreffin's hurt some. That's it.
Oh, whatever. No one's really injured.
Yeah, Dreffin's the only one.
I still have 8 health damage.
Oh, we're stopping. I'm rolling for health.
Since you guys are stopping, you can start to recover health, but you guys were constantly moving, so you don't have to roll, it's fine.
Yeah. I forget how that works.
Think about it, Dreffen. They won't expect that we're going, that we're heading in that direction. We can also find out what happened to Vithir and the others when they, if they're dead or if they got taken or what. We'll lessen the group. So that they'll be able to move more quietly, because we are loud right now.
Then yeah. Shut up.
Sorry, I'm. He's not actually talking that loud. I'm talking that loud because Mike. I'm trying not to whisper. I'm trying to keep stage voice and not whisper.
Yes.
Just project when you whisper.
It's harder than anything when you don't have practice with it.
Anyway, Yeah, so, and if we find out what happened, then if Vither's alive, then we can maybe get a message to you guys, or if he's not, then, well, we can figure out from there.
Oh, Vither's still alive.
That's probably the other two
are dead. Dropping the size. Looks over at you, Audrey. Gives you an apologetic look.
I'm gonna just... But people can't see me. I'm shaking my head. I'm going to shake my head at him.
We're gonna go and make this right. You do what you need to do for Vithir. Get whatever help is there, and we're gonna do what we can back at the town.
No.
Where are you going exactly?
To the town.
The actual town.
Yes.
To do what?
To go and die like a bunch of idiots.
I'm not gonna die.
Well, what are you going to try to do?
Something that none of you have the balls to do. All you cowards.
Is it Barkley saying this?
Yeah.
Okay, I was gonna smack whoever it was that was saying it, but it's Barkley, so I'm not gonna hit a child.
I would.
Then you hit him.
No, I don't care about it. Well, if you're going to try and go kill those witches or whatever, dude. I'm not gonna try to stop you, but I feel like it's a bad idea. And if you do manage somehow to do it, then good luck getting out of there.
Trevin will say, make sure he doesn't do anything stupid and that he stays alive.
Good luck, man. Yeah? Good luck, but we need to keep going.
And he was silent kind of during it, kind of has his head down, but as you guys, as Barkley starts stepping away, well, first Dreffen goes and gives you a hug, Hazel, and says, I'll make it back.
You're injured.
I'm fine. I'll make it back.
If you die, I'm going to find a way to find your corpse, and I'm going to desecrate it. Because you're going to piss me off.
I don't even know what to say to that.
I'll go catch up with Barkley real quick.
The person who had his head low, sorry, was Leo Flynn. As those two step away, he starts to walk towards them with them. You're going to catch up to Barkley?
Yeah.
Okay.
Barkley, please let me talk to you before you go.
What?
You're a really smart kid. Please don't take any unnecessary risks if you don't need to. Survival is the most important thing.
That's why I'm doing this.
So sorry that you have to do that. You're being put through all this.
Why don't you do something about it? Then he'll turn and walk away.
Dang. What a sick burn.
And as he walks by, just kind of puts his hand on your shoulder and squeezes it a little bit. He's angry. Don't miss him. And then
that's right,
he walks off.
So out of all of you, you're the strongest fighter, right, Leah?
Fighter, but...
For the record, there is now you four, Eric, and Sophie. Well, and...
Well,
and Han.
Right.
And Han, yeah.
Isn't Han an okay fighter?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, he was,
he has a 4 in fighting.
Yeah.
Me too. No, I don't. I have a 3.
Oh, I have a 4
in fighting. I have a 4 in athletics.
Nice.
So, if you hit him, you do...
But you carry around a bow still.
And a knife. I don't have a sword.
Isn't knife like agility?
No, that's a dagger.
After fight or athletics, but okay. Mine's 2. But I don't have a sword.
Can you guys trudge on?
Since I'm in the back, I'm going to keep an ear out.
Actually, Sophie's behind you, but yeah, you're in the back.
I'm pretty much in the back. Keep an ear out for stuff.
Alright, roll that awareness. Notice.
I don't have specialties.
Wow.
That's why you're not doing as good as Mickey's, because he had a bunch of notice.
21.
21?
Yeah.
21. I'll mark it down.
I'm gonna glance over my shoulder a few times just to see if the gang that split off are still there. Like, in eyesight.
No, when they walked away and they're gone.
We're in a pretty, like,
good luck to you, men!
We're in a pretty, like,
Godspeed!
Area, right? Yeah, you guys are walking. You guys are walking through a forest, so okay. They disappear fairly quickly with the trees in the way.
I got 3 hour. Actually, it's more than that since the town.
We just lost it.
Where was the town in correlation to the, like? Was it like farther south from the homestead?
To the eastern.
I will either allow a cunning memory or survival orientation.
I'll do cunning memory.
Wow, what a bold choice.
Yep.
How utterly
Oh wow, that's music for this situation.
Almost got a Yahtzee.
One off. Was your cunning a 5?
Yes.
Yeah. He's...
And then all I get to use all bonus dice as test dice.
He's the
Okay, right. So you have like 30, right?
35.
Yeah, okay, easy. Yeah, so it's to the south, a little bit to the southwest because of the angle of the continent.
Okay.
It was you just wanted to know generally what direction, right? Was that it?
Yes, okay. And also follow up. So we've gone a slow 3 hours.
Yes,
north.
Half-west.
So they have a slow 3 hours back. I'm trying to guess like how much time it take them to get to the town.
Mm-hmm. Probably go a little faster than that.
It's a lot of mental math, Mister.
Roll me a cunning decipher.
If it's not memory, I'm just rolling.
Okay.
Or
logic, I mean, kind of logic.
14.
14?
Logically.
So, on foot, it'll probably take a day to get to the village, but you don't know how fast or slow they're going to be going. You don't know if they're going to be running most of the time or going super slow. So, yeah. Maybe they'll make it to the town in a day.
I wish we had, like, any info where we were going besides...
To the north?
North.
That's all we need.
Maybe that's all you need.
No.
We'll know them when we see them.
Yeah, we'll know the 2 specific people we need to find.
That guy looks like a...
They'll have, like, little press markers over their head. We'll be like, them.
He didn't really have time to tell you more.
Northeast. We try and head towards the edge of the forest.
You want to head to the northeast and try to head to the edge of the forest?
Yeah, right.
Okay. All right, that's right. All right.
We'd be going northwest this
time. Yeah. All right. You do not reach the... Actually, everyone roll me an endurance real quick.
Son of a bitch.
Start with the right.
16.
Oh, pass.
12.
Pass.
11.
Pass.
14.
Pass.
Gas.
Come in.
Thanks.
Hello.
I got him.
And we're back.
I don't know what dragons there are.
I don't know. I'm just
dragons.
Dragons. All right.
What a thing to come back to. Just I don't know what dragons there are.
You guys are able to. Actually, wait. I can actually roll. Let me roll for these guys real quick. You're good, and you're good. Cool. So you guys are able to keep pushing yourselves despite the exhaustion kicking in. The weather had started to get colder, but with your constant movement.
Awake.
Come on.
You feel.
Nathan, they were saying naughty adult words.
Oh, I thought I muted it. Do you want to mute it? You put that hard.
Yeah, we're the worst.
We're going to get banned from YouTube.
Oh no, I'm going to lose all my ad revenue. Oh wait, everything's copyrighted because of the music I play. I don't care about the money. I don't do this for the money. Oh yeah, by the way, anyone who wishes to give money for...
discount code.
I'm not
talking for G Fuel.
I'm
just
talking I'm not talking to online people.
If we push enough product
for all the miniatures I bought, people should give me money. Anyway,
do you have a problem shaving with crappy Walmart razors? Try Harry's razors.
You're not a dick. You're a man.
Sasquatch.
Sasquatch.
Sasquatch. Dr. Squatch.
Oh, that's what it was. Dr. Squatch. I see that ad all the time.
I keep getting the ads. Sorry.
Forrest. Walking tired.
Yes.
We are not tired,
but pushing through it. It would normally be freezing cold. I mean, not freezing. It would be a little cold, but you guys marching makes it warm. It is also raining, so you guys are soaked through.
I left all my cool clothes at home.
You're fancy.
And I don't have a backpack like everyone.
Oh! roll me a d6.
Oh no.
Yeah. Ooh. Okay. Oh, I should roll for Eric. Okay.
What's your paper got?
Yeah,
wet?
See if your paper got wet.
Oh.
It's very nothing warm. On me.
I'll take you guys should all have a bag of resources and stuff, right?
Yeah.
Everyone does, yes.
Those of us who remembered to have it, and she gave a bag to all of us. Did you not carry your bag with you?
Oh, I did carry it with me.
You threw it.
Until I threw it.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
I forgot about that.
You dumb man. You're so smart. How can you act so stupid? Why would you throw away your resources?
He was distracting the person.
I mean, distraction.
But the sun is starting to set. The rain this point has died down. It's just drips around you.
That's what you think. Storm.
Are you making it continue on? Okay.
We have one destiny point.
Oh, right? Yeah? I'm going to use a destiny point to put the sun back in the sky.
It's day again.
Oh, it's day forever now. I'm going to make it start snowing.
So, what are you,
cancel.
Are you guys wanting to keep going? What are you doing?
We look at our survival.
I'm tired.
Let's... Can we find a place to stop for the night? Cold. Lots of complainers.
Yeah, so we're looking for a stop. For a good area where we can cover ourselves easily.
Feet are tired.
Good stopping area for our.
Cover yourselves? In what way?
I'm wearing my fancy shoes.
With large branches.
I mean, there's plenty of large branches.
With all the elephant leaves that are around.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
And like an open, clear area.
Those would be perfect.
Maybe. Well, not super big and open. Because we don't want to be dead in the open.
Okay.
Because then we're in the open.
Because then we'll be dead.
Yeah.
In the open.
Wow.
But.
And then we'll have to play as the NPCs who left.
I can't play as a girl, sorry.
I will play.
I'll let you know what I'm like this the rest of the session.
Roll me a survival.
Okay.
I don't know which ones I rolled. There was multiple over here. Hold on.
I was counting more many than I keep it, you know.
Well, I rolled pretty bad.
Thing. Oh, boy. Mickey!
Ugh. You're good at that. I don't like it.
What are you doing?
11.
11?
Two threes.
And I mean, you find a reasonable area, I guess, yeah. You can't find a dry area. It's all wet. But there's plenty of branches around that you can cut if you're wanting to cover stuff. Okay.
We're gonna miss this place.
There are roots and things, like, what? There's always...
We're gonna miss the forest?
We're gonna miss the fucking place we're supposed to be going, because we just know a direction.
I know. So we're heading towards the edge of the forest.
We can keep an eyeball out.
Mm-hmm. Alright.
Smart.
What are you guys doing for the evening?
I am laying down. We're making a place to lay down.
Alright.
Smart. No one else is saying anything.
No one else is saying anything. So I assume you're all just standing there with, like, buffoons.
Correct.
Miss Audrey Hazel is the only...
So leaned against the tree.
Alright, he's spending the night leaning up against the tree.
Oh, okay. You didn't say what we're just doing for the
night. We're making camp so we can sleep. We should take shifts.
Are you guys wanting to eat food, drink water? Because that's important when it comes to when you're out in the wilderness and you have limited supplies. Are you making a campfire or not? If so, what are you doing to make a campfire? Because it's wet out. What are you guys doing? If you don't tell me, because you guys went through the swamp. You know that I want specifics of what you guys are doing, this survival thing, or I'm going to assume the worst. So, tell me, what's happening?
No, we're not making a campfire because it gives off smoke, too easy to find.
Okay.
That seems smart.
Is there a nice dry patch?
There is not. It is completely wet.
Sounds
sorry, funny. Guys. I had to play God.
I'll pull leaves on the ground and fetal position.
How many rations did we pack?
Bag? Let's see, I believe you guys have one water skin, and I think it was, let's see, how many gulps did I measure for a water skin before?
Four
gulps?
It usually was a quarter a day.
Yeah, I think it was about a quarter a day.
Yeah, a water skin would usually last us around 4 days in the last campaign.
Okay. So each of you have one water skin. And then you probably have about, in each bag, probably 6 meals worth of food.
Meals.
Okay. This is when you mark it down, because...
I'm gonna mark down 5 and 3.
There you go.
6 meals of food.
5 and 3.
Yeah.
Oh, because you're having some tonight?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just nothing to remember.
Yeah, because he doesn't have anything.
Oh.
Rip bag.
I'll share my food with you. I will hand you one food.
I shall take the one food.
He has one food.
Consume it.
This is so awkward.
So I have 5 food.
Yeah, the one who's making it awkward.
Actually, you know what? I'm not gonna lay down. I'm gonna take first watch.
No, I'm first watch.
Oh.
Fight.
I'm gonna.
So he says, I'm joining. Can I join you? Or should we split?
We should probably split. Okay, I'm gonna take one person shifts.
Yeah, they're separating.
I think we should do two person
shifts.
Two
person shifts? Alright. Well then.
You're taking first with him. You're not taking second.
Oh.
We're doing two person shifts.
Okay. Well, I will.
Can go second, I guess.
Eric's like, I guess I'll stay up with him.
Yeah, you take person shifts.
And then I'll go last with Will. Since Han's not here, he can sleep.
Okay. Dead man sleep. He's gonna sleep like a canoe.
Find as dry a spot as you can. Get as much rest as you can. Removing first thing sun up.
I want to fall asleep sitting up against a tree.
I'm going to climb a tree.
Okay, the trees here are fairly thick. How are you wanting to make sure you stay up there when you fall asleep? You're watching, right.
I'm just gonna sit on a large, probably lower branch.
So those of you who are awake, since you've had a very difficult afternoon, I need you to roll me an endurance, and then roll me an awareness notice.
11 endurance!
Luke texted back saying, I have not forgotten.
About?
You weren't there for that talk. Something like a canoe.
The weird way he said.
It's like a canoe, and we're like, canoe!
It's an
the ways joke. Of
you
the mummy.
You an inside joke because you were late.
The mummy.
Today, you were late.
Yeah. Alright, so what'd you get with your endurance?
11.
11?
13.
Alright, you both pass.
Yeah.
With that, so you're able to stay awake. And what's your awareness notices?
13.
13?
8.
8? Alright. So you're sitting there for your watch. The sun has set. The other is trying to get comfortable and trying
also
to go to sleep.
Eyes. I can see in the dark.
That's true.
He's
nice.
He's a night vision.
Epic gamer.
Yep.
Epic gamer move.
You hear in the distance howls. You recognize that easily as wolves.
Okay. Oh no, I'm scared. The one thing I'm scared of.
What, you think I wouldn't have wolves?
I already fought some.
Show up.
Okay, they're in the distance.
Yep, they're in the distance.
Keep an eye out for them.
Alright. By the time, you through your watch, you hear multiple howls, and it seems to be getting a bit closer. By the time your watch is over, they're not near you. The howls would come, like say, in front of you, and then probably like half an hour or so later, they're off to your left somewhere down the road.
Okay.
But it's hard to tell exact. It's not hard to tell how far or how many are in like that. You just hear wolf howls in the distance.
Okay.
My awareness is so bad because I'm terrified.
Probably.
That's a good in-game explanation for a shitty roll.
It comes to the end of your watch. You still hear the howls every once in a while, Audrey.
Lexi.
Mm-hmm. That's what I was. I need to roll me a will. First, roll me a d6 because of your fear thing.
5.
I thought that only happens in combat.
Happens when the fear is around.
Yeah.
all right. This combat.
Roll me.
Yeah, mine's combat.
Roll me a will with a -1 dime.
Okay, Josh, that. Come here.
I hate this joke so much. You still roll the die, but
yeah.
How do you think
four.
I feel anytime someone says roll max?
Yeah.
It happens a lot more.
You don't know how long it takes you, but you lay there, scared. for a while before you finally just end up passing out from exhaustion. The second watch is...
Yeah, I'm going to wake up him and Eric. And I'm gonna... I'm gonna tell them... It sounds like there are wolves not super close, but fairly nearby. They sound like they're getting a lot closer.
Wolves. Great.
What? So then I'm going to use my big, burly bear cloak as a blanket.
Yeah, you're probably the only one who's staying warm. Unless anyone else has any winter clothes?
I did.
My clothes are long sleeves, but they don't count as winter clothes.
I mean,
I
could say I was wearing them, but...
If it matters... Yes.
So, how... Go ahead.
If it matters, I have fallen asleep nearby Will, but not next to.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I don't know.
So, how cold would you have said the day was before we ran away?
Before you left?
Before we...
Probably, like,
Would have been enough to where I would have been wearing my northern clothing.
I don't know, that's up to you. It was, like, north, like, lower 60s.
I don't know, then. Would you like me to roll?
Keep it to a luck, then. Odds you didn't wear it, evens you didn't.
I did.
You wore it? Alright.
So, I have northern clothing. Whatever that does.
It's currently soaked, but...
Yes.
Even then, it's better than not wearing it. Mm-hmm. As the night has come through because of the the overcast, plus the rain, plus now nighttime.
So now all
I own... It's gotten quite cold in here.
All I own is northern clothing now.
Nice. But we'll get to what happens with the cold later.
Cool.
First, you and your brother. Zero for what? Oh, okay. Okay, I see. So you and your brother's watch. You had a little bit of sleep, so you don't have to roll endurances, but do roll awareness notice. Blasphemy.
Oof.
Seven.
Oh, you rolled worse than your brother, and he didn't roll that great. So, it's hard to see anything because of the darkness. Your eyes have adjusted a little bit, but it's still
fairly hard because the light is being fairly kept out by the trees and stuff.
There's you know, plenty of places around where there's a little bit more light and a little bit of movement from something. Maybe it's just your imagination. Just seems like there's always something around. Always just on edge. And being cold definitely doesn't help with that feeling. Very uncomfortable. Your brother kind of like scoots up close to you just for a little bit of body warmth.
Yeah.
He opens up his bag, checks his stuff. Oh, thank God the papers are dry. Oh
my gosh, the papers.
Check yours. I need to make extra sure that they stay covered.
Yeah.
You doing okay?
I don't know. I hope to think I'm not gonna get out of this. It's pretty bleak.
Everything here, yeah. Feels like it's trying to kill us. It's hostile, and those sounds of wolves out there does not help at all.
Yeah. I miss home. It's cool being somewhere new, I guess.
I mean, I wanted, you know, I wanted to go places, but not like this. Definitely not like this. Not being hunted. I was just making progress as well. In the town. Making some friends. Getting some people to like me. Making myself known. There is... But... Gone again. Every time. Every time we're making plans. Every time I feel like we're... I'm getting somewhere with my life. It's these stupid Norsemen.
So we just have to take it day at a time. Super cliche, but...
Do you think the others who stayed behind made it? Really fought for us.
I hope they did, but probably at least half of them are dead. I have to guess. They look like it was going too well when we ran off.
It's crazy. Do you ever regret leaving home?
I was thinking about that. If I just stayed home with mom, I would never have been in that town.
Sure, that town didn't really treat you that well, but it's still home and it's familiar. Probably foolish to think about such things.
But it's hard not to.
What's something that you want to do that you can do before you die? Does that make sense? Like we could die at any moment. What's something that you want to do before then? Any of the girls here you want to kiss? Any of the guys? I don't know, I'm not judging. A story you've been putting off writing, or history, I mean, right?
If there's anything I want to do before I die that I can do right now, if that's what you're saying. Most of the stuff that I want would require more time. My whole life I've been, at least most of my life, I've been wanting to. Stories that people will read and hear about for generations, but if we don't make it out, our stories don't make it out. It's not really possible.
Are you wanting to give up on that, or keep pushing forward? because of those goals. I've been asking myself that for the past few weeks, and when we're in this situation, I'm just thinking about it more. How much life is worth fighting for when we're in a world where everything is trying to kill us? If it's wise to hold on to those goals or hope, or just stop fighting it.
I've mostly been focused on just making it out of here when faced with possibly dying every day almost. You start to think less about those big grand ideas you had and more about just making it through and
you're holding on to the hope. How? I tried to, you know, I've tried to help lift spirits and stuff around here, but it's... half of it feels... a lot of it feels like I'm just faking it. I encourage other people and tell them we're gonna make it out, but I don't... it's hard for me to believe it myself. How do you believe it?
Saying I believe it. What else would you want to hopefully?
It looks like Barkley has pretty much given up on trying to escape. Getting back to that life, it seems like he's just set on causing as much destruction as he can. Seems like he's given up on the notion of going home. So he's just doing something else. I almost decided to go with him, but one, I didn't want to leave you, and two, I would probably just get in the way. Because I was close to giving up on hope to go home. I know this isn't easy, I'm sorry. Oh! Don't put your tail in there, Tuck. Sorry, buddy.
Jump scare.
Yeah, jump scare. Ah! I'm sorry, I'll just stop asking these questions. It's fine. It's foolish. I'll just keep being the voice of excitement and joy and striving forward. Even if I am struggling with it myself. Sound good?
You don't actually feel that way. You have to.
Well, just because I feel that way, that doesn't mean I want others to feel that way, too. I don't want to be like Barkley, who feels like trash and tries to make other people feel like trash.
There's a difference between making people feel bad and... sharing your true doubts and fears. I mean, everyone's feeling bad. Yeah. Maybe they would better misery than human. Hearing your bubbly ache.
I mean, everyone.
Attitude.
Well, I mean, someone has to express that sort of attitude, right? I mean, everyone else is.
I'm just saying, if.
Did you like me better when I was expressing my hope, like sharing my hope and talking about how we're all going to make it out and it's going to be fine? Or did you prefer me talking like I was just a moment ago, talking about giving up?
I think it's good to have a balance, probably. Don't tell anyone you're feeling that way, then. They would never know. They could have said something to make you feel differently.
I wish I had more paper for a journal.
Yeah.
I used to have one back at Havergate. Basically, just writing down my life, as boring as it was. Now that crazy things are happening, I don't have anything much to write with.
Did you actually write it as boring?
Or did you? No, of course not. It was boring for me, but I'm not going to make it boring for anyone who ends up reading it.
Big.
Those papers were thrown to the wind. Years of writing. Thrown to the wind.
Yeah.
I want to find the one who did that. And not kill him because I didn't know I couldn't, but make him write it all so he knows how painful it is, how long it can take. Have you ever run to the point you've gotten blisters?
Just once.
Sometimes I feel like I'm an addict.
Yeah, yeah.
Sometimes I look at my fingers and see the blister I have there and tell myself that I've wrote enough then. That's a little dark. There's a reason I kept kept asking for your paper. I like writing.
Yeah.
But I'm not.
I try and moisturize my fingers. It helps.
Hey, I stole some of the mead back at the village. You want some?
What the heck?
There it is.
Better than our crappy dry wines at home.
Yeah. Love this stuff. I want to drink it all tonight. I know I shouldn't, though. One more. Ah! Want one more?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Is it time to get someone else?
Yeah. Sure.
It's been 3 hours.
Yeah, definitely. Alright, and next up is Sophie and Will.
Yeah, Will.
Staring. Roll me that awareness notice.
Winch. 19.
That's a bad roll.
Not too bad.
Okay.
Okay.
It's actually an average roll.
Oh, okay. I guess I just got above average. You and Sophie, I'm keeping an eye out. Oh yeah, she also has the night eyes. Cheaters, no. They just spend a lot of their life in the dark.
What are they, cavemen?
They were born in the dark, molded by it.
Man, you keep silent during the watch? You hear some howls in the distance? Actually, let's see if Sophie knows that.
I think I'd keep silent.
Wow, good roll, Sophie. She will kind of like perk up at some of the at one of the howls.
Oh, I'm perking up at all.
Yeah. Those wolves are hunting. They don't bother humans unless they're hungry. So.
Do they sound hungry?
I can't tell by how. Let's hope they're not hungry enough to go after us and our food. They should be easy to scare away, though. Maybe. The wolves here are huge.
Do we have anything to make, like, a torch?
Yeah.
We have one of those ready to...
Fire is... can attract, though, the hunters.
I mean, if it's attracting the hunters or getting rid of the wolves that are on us. Play it by ear.
And through that watch, there isn't much. The howls end up dying down. And the sun begins to rise. I need everyone, except for you, Leo.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone but Leo. Actually, you get an extra test die. Will actually no a flat plus two. Everyone roll me an endurance. An endurance No, just an endurance. What'd you get?
I guess it'd be my best thing.
Nine. Okay.
14.
Okay.
Nine.
Yeah,
nine.
When you couldn't stealth.
It's fine. I needed to ever roll stealth like woo! During the run. Kind of like right now.
actually, she would. So when Sophie goes to sleep, she would. So you used your bear cloak when she was sleeping. So Sophie would have wanted to use your bear cloak. When you were awake and she was sleeping.
Okay.
And then for the second watch, like wrapped up together. And then, yeah. So. Actually, I do need you roll just with an extra test.
Okay.
Yeah!
Woo! Two sixes and a five.
Okay.
And a three, but that's whatever.
That barrel cloak saved Sophie getting some problems from the cold. Now,
Injury.
Huh?
Injury.
She doesn't have any injuries.
She doesn't have injuries.
No. Okay, go ahead, sorry.
Then you...
I take the injury.
No frostbite.
No. Wait, what'd you get? You got a 9, right?
Sorry.
Oh, you got like an 11.
Just keep going, I don't want you to interrupt.
Okay.
You say as you keep interrupting.
Yeah, I don't understand. So, you didn't do that. That's... Okay. So... This next morning, what are you guys eating / drinking for your rations?
Half a ration?
Sure.
I eat a ration.
For a meal.
And don't forget drinking.
I drank last night.
I will drink a little bit. I'll drink an eighth. Of a scheme.
So you just have more slice
for now.
Okay.
And then probably the other half at some point in the other time of day.
I'll drink an eighth and
then... Now we're heading... We'll go straight east.
Roll me a survival orientation. You're heading straight east? Okay.
Will, do you need a drink?
I'll be fine for now.
20.
20?
Mm-hmm.
And very nice. Very nice rolls.
No,
so,
21.
You guys just maybe going for a couple... Are you going slow and silent again? Continuing to do that? Or
a little
speed?
A little bit faster, but,
it's regular speed.
But
okay.
Still trying to leave no trail.
That's going to slow you down
yeah.
A lot then again. Okay.
Then... No, I got a 22, actually.
22?
Mm-hmm. I can't do math.
All right.
Josh. Hold on, I need to double check a rule thing. Again. No, it's just Josh. Sorry, Will at this point has gone 24 hours without drinking. Mm-hmm. Let's see.
Just find like a big leaf on the ground. There's probably still water. Is that the right? For sure. For sure. Or you could just like get your blanket and just
stuff that. Hey, you're right. It has been 24 hours since I've drank anything.
What's your endurance?
Three?
Takes a sip of water.
Roll me an endurance.
Whoops. Eight.
Okay. You're fine. Oh, that music got intense for that.
You haven't drank anything.
I didn't mean for it to get that intense. I guess it does what it pleases. Alright. About halfway through that day, you begin to hear what sounds like whooshing. Water breaking up against rocks.
Okay.
Good old whooshing.
I hear whooshing. Either someone shooting arrows at us and they're like whooshing by. When I heard whooshing, I would not imagine the ocean.
What sound would you describe it as?
Not whooshing.
What then? Tell me.
Crashing.
So you hear the sound of crashing. What does that make you think of?
Still not the ocean.
Exactly.
But a little bit more than whooshing.
You could say shh. Just ching.
Okay, you hear ching.
I duck for cover. I don't know what I'm covering.
What are you ducking from? What did that sound like to think of?
Nothing. All right, we hear it.
Yes, you hear
water.
It.
Wow, I hear an ocean.
Dude, your word pictures.
Are you sure it's not whooshing?
I don't know, would you describe it as a whooshing, Cedric?
What are you doing, Leo?
Yeah, Leo, what
you end up... Are you continuing to walk that way?
What, we heard whooshing?
Oh my god! You hear the sound of ocean water! Breaking up against rocks to the ahead of you.
Hey, yo, head that way.
And as you head that way, you end up coming out of the trees, and you can see in the distance as there is a cliffside. Not a high cliff, quote-unquote cliff. About 20 or so feet above water level, and you see the ocean.
Okay. I don't know where we are.
The ocean.
What he said.
Yeah, we're at the ocean.
What direction is the ocean in? Is it to the east of us?
You're on a continent.
Yeah,
so
I'm aware. But is it the north, south, or what?
East. It's east. Yeah.
East is that way, right? On the map?
Depends on which way the map is facing. If you're looking at a map, then it would be
to
the right.
To the right, okay. So, yes, the...
Mm-hmm.
After all that sea of thieves, you don't know.
I've always been terrible about that. All I can think of is that we passed it.
Long.
Or we could keep going north.
So you went north for a bit, and northwestish a bit, then you went straight east. Well, then you started going northeast a bit, then you went straight east, and then you hit this.
Mm-hmm.
You can see northward and southward that the trees kind of go that way. I'll go each way. And
if I look south, how long does the cliff run?
The cliff itself, I don't know, like it goes on for a little bit and then it kind of slopes down and it forms like a beach down there and then it picks up a bit more further down there and it goes on.
Does it run with the forest as far as I can see?
It's relatively parallel with the forest. Okay.
Relative to what?
What? The ocean, the...
It's a...
What is with you tonight, Josh?
I'm just trying to mess with you.
He's hype.
Should I just ignore all your questions?
You too.
Okay.
Why
do you
keep asking?
You seem tired today, buddy.
Thinking. Okay. I don't know where we are. how far does it go if I look to the north? Do I see an end to, like, where it...
Not within your eyesight, okay. No. Not in your eyesight.
Okay, and then it runs with the forest all to the north as well?
Relatively, yeah. It's not like a straight line, but yeah, relatively.
Like, stays within close.
Yeah.
I guess we head back south. All I can think of is that we passed it.
How do you know it's not further north?
Because we have no idea how.
I will give you something that I said last time, but it makes sense if you don't remember because it was 2 weeks ago. Vithir told you to head north until you leave the forest.
Oh, he said leave the forest.
Past a barren hill, the second house past the barren hill.
Okay, I didn't hear the forest part. Well, then never mind, we keep going north.
Are you wanting to go along the beach? Well, the cliff and beach area.
We're next to a cliff.
Yeah.
How high? It's
about 20 feet above the water. This section of it.
We'll head inwards just like a little bit, like 100 feet at most.
So you're wanting to go into the tree line?
Yeah. Okay. Keep going north.
Alrighty. Sounds good. It passes noon as you guys are continuing into the afternoon. Mm-hmm. Audrey, roll me an endurance.
Can I keep an eye out for
sleepy bitch syndrome?
Like small hunting prey, like rabbits or things that I can just like shoot
sleepy bitch syndrome
as we go along, I guess.
Roll me a perception awareness bonus. What'd you get?
Seven. Perception, definitely. keep an eye out for just like small rodents or tracks.
Dealing with the
tracks,
really case of SBS.
Yeah.
50. Hold on that a second. Oh, that's what I want. Okay. What's your endurance?
3.
Okay. Yeah. You got some sleep, so you're just very sleepy right now. Sleep wasn't that great.
I knew it.
You're fine right now. 15? Yeah. This place is rich with wildlife.
Mm-hmm.
It's not too hard to spot something.
Okay.
Whose leg is that? Is that yours, Connor?
That's mine.
Oh, okay.
Wait, no. Oh, that talks.
You can see both of my knees. That's true. Okay, as soon as I see it, I'm just gonna... Shut
up. You're scaring too loud.
And then... I'll just take a shot at it.
Alright, go for it. Roll the hit.
Do I get bonus because it doesn't know I'm here? Stealth bonus dice? Or test.
Considering the massive group, it knows you're there, and the bunny is currently looking at you, right. ready to leap away.
And I take a lesser action to aim for bonus dice.
Sure.
Ha! That's kinked.
Kinked.
16.
16? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you nail that thing. It, like, starts to jump, and you get it, like, right in the butt.
Cool. I will collect my prize, and we will venge forth.
Ah!
You just keep it on the arrow, just...
Alright.
I'm not doing that.
And there are a bunch of hazards like in the swamp with this place. You guys are just walking around in the wilderness.
Yeah, there's people hunting us.
No biggie. Yeah, no biggie about that.
Hazards.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, I mean, I'll just keep an eye out for more. I want to try to get as many extra rations as possible.
At least they don't know where we're going, because we don't know where we're going.
They're probably just as
crazy. If you would like to do that, it will slow you down.
Okay, never mind.
Okay.
We'll keep going.
You're gonna track Balding.
Alright. And I'm guessing no one stopped for anything on lunch, and that evening comes. How are you wanting to set up your camp this time? Pretty much, like, are you wanting to be in the trees, out of the trees? Try to find, like, a more softer, chiller area to lay down.
Yeah, maybe a grassier area.
Okay. Roll me in a survival.
Whatever. 14.
14? Okay, you can find a relatively decent place.
Okay. Everything dry at the moment?
Drier, but not perfectly dry, no.
Didn't think playing God would affect us this hard.
Right? Storms affect everyone. It did prevent them from shooting you more, though. So, it may have caused some issues down the road, but it also prevented some of you from taking injuries and or wounds.
Mm-hmm. Alright. I'm going to set up a small fire for a short time to cook this rabbit. And then it is being put out.
So if you're doing that, go ahead and roll me, I don't know what else, so a survival.
Give me dice.
A lot of survival rolls.
Survival boy. That one's actually really bad. 11.
Okay. What would you get with a... actually, let me do something real quick.
You beat a challenge.
Nope. Sophie tries to help and is having trouble as well. It takes a... You guys are successfully able to make a very small fire.
Mm-hmm.
But it takes a while because you're dealing with wet wood.
Wet, smoky wood.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wet, smoky wood.
Okay.
So it... Yeah. So it's dark. Completely dark by the time you get it lit. And start cooking it.
Okay. I guess I'm making it smoke. Yeah. And then start cooking it. And then as soon as it's cooked, I'm just... Put the fire out.
Sophie... starts cooking it.
Okay. Yeah. How to do that.
Yeah.
Just burn it. Then it's good.
No.
It'll burn all the bacteria.
Oh, wait. But who's skinning it?
I'll do it.
Roll. Let's see how well you skin to see how much meat you're able to get.
It was 5 or 8.
There's already not much meat on there.
10.
Just skin it like 15, in Red Dead. You pick it up and just peel 15. Off the skin.
Is it a rabbit?
So, two meals worth.
Two meals worth?
Yeah, it's actually pretty interesting how they skin around it. Like, how's this poison? And it's off. Yeah, two meals worth. They're small meals, but in your guys' case, meals. Do you guys eat tonight? Do you drink water tonight?
Going to hand my water to the bill. You need to fucking drink. Get a drink before you die.
What are the water skins made of? Leather, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll drink half of one.
Take a small drink.
An eighth of a sip.
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Do you drink any, Audrey? And eat?
Yeah, we can split another ration.
Split again? Okay.
Because we don't... No, eat a whole one, and then we get rabbit.
Yay!
Okay.
And then I'll eat the other rabbit.
I'm down three.
Okay.
Three meals anyways, so...
You liked me enough to share rabbit.
Just doesn't want you to die.
Compared to everyone else here, it's also...
Alright, so who's keeping watch? Same thing as last time?
Sure.
Don't fix it.
Alright.
Yeah, we didn't die last time.
You two, roll me an endurance.
I was actually going to say I should probably take last watch because I'm dealing with sleepy bitch syndrome. Because I'm falling asleep as we're walking. And it's not good.
Well, then...
You can switch with them.
Go ahead, take last watch with Will.
Okay. So, you and Sophie?
Yeah, and Sophie will do first watch. Alright. Roll me an endurance first. Should be fairly
easy. I dropped one.
No.
Unless you roll absolute trash.
Trash.
Trash. You're getting very tired, but you're able to barely keep yourself awake. Sophie kind of helps. Like, you start falling asleep and she gives you a little pinch.
Take that wound.
You're gonna take that
wound. You're right.
Oh, man.
You let your girl pinch you, dude.
Abusive. Toxic relationships.
Jesus. Most of the time she's quiet until one point when she says, "We're gonna get them all out of the forest alive. Right?"
Yeah. What it looks like. We should be able to. If we need to, we can slow down for more food. We can see if a river branches off somewhere. I think we'll make it out.
I can't let anyone else die under a watch. I don't know what it'll do to me.
Problem is, I don't really know what we're doing once we're out of here. Once we get where we're trying to go, how they're gonna react or what.
We're gonna have to be really careful when we go approach the village.
Yeah.
We have to make sure we pick the right house. There's no telling when the last time Vithir was there. Maybe the village changed. He doesn't know. I wish he could have sent more. Through the watch. Well, not through the watch. But at some point, there is a howl. The wolves are still there. Roll me a survival hunt.
Yeah.
Yeah. 18.
From what you know of wolves. Either they're tracking something that's going with you, or you guys.
Well, sounds like someone's hunting us.
Let's keep our eyes open then. But through your watch, there's nothing. Besides the howler as well. But it's rare. Before you
How
wake.
Close is it?
Roll me either an awareness notice or a survival orientation.
I'm a cool survival boy.
Food 17, 16.
16?
Mm-hmm.
maybe roughly a mile-ish. At least, but it's hard to tell. The fact that there's trees and stuff, it can help screw with the sound.
Yeah.
And also the fact that it's wet.
For when the next watch comes, I'll tell them to keep their eyes and ears peeled. Especially,
wait, why?
Besides the end.
Yeah, and Eric interrupts you. Why, besides normal?
Because it sounds like we're being hunted by wolves.
What the? They're still following us? They're still...
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I'll keep my eyes wide open. Does he have a weapon on him? He pulls out a knife.
That's all I have. Tell Will and Audrey the same thing when you wake them up.
Okay. Yeah, we will. Fun, yeah. So, you and Eric roll awareness notices.
Yeah. What did you roll?
Oh. Nice.
How many dice do you roll?
So, a little ways into your watch, you don't notice it until it's pretty much right on top of you.
Gosh.
As you hear what sounds like footsteps, and stepping out from the darkness, kind of in your sight, is a human figure. Eric's looking in a different direction right now. Oh shit! And
wow.
Well, it's been fun, guys.
Those of you who are asleep, actually, probably only Will. Will, you wake up to the sound of.
Oh shit!
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
I look for the sound. I don't know.
Figure's just kind of standing there. It's a big, big human, like big, thick boy.
Who goes there?
See that in Saxon.
I'm still getting noise.
I've got to say, it was a hell of a time tracking you down.
I hear this.
Yes, it's in Norse.
I start, like, violently poking people.
Steps forward, and you can see a few more features. Long black hair, big old beard going down, like, almost belly-ish area, and a massive sword strapped onto his back.
Do I see anyone else?
Roll me an awareness notice.
I rolled. 19.
You barely see it. What looks like two other figures standing probably 15 feet behind him, leaning up against trees.
I get poked awake, or...
Yeah, you got poked awake.
So those are the only two I see. I don't see, like...
He...
So the direction they came from, that was from... I guess I wouldn't really know the direction.
Right, he, pulls off a stick that he had strapped on a pack on his back,
stabs one end of it onto the ground and starts
Sophie.
I've poked like
everyone. Yeah, everyone's like waking up as he lights it. You can see him a bit better. The people that were behind him, you can't see him at all now that there's light in the way.
Gotcha. I meant more like I was trying to look at the opposite direction of where I saw them as well to see if like we've been
you don't see anyone else.
Okay.
With them. But he just kind of was that there. Now we can see each other a bit more. So.
I'm gonna start readying my spear.
Oh, don't.
Pick up a rock.
I advise that you don't. I want to
get up real quickly.
Kind of looks at all of you. It's fascinating what Vithir is willing to do for all of you. Risking his own life. Oh, he's fine.
I assume he's speaking in Norse.
Yeah.
Dang it.
What?
He's fine. The others... not so fine.
Kill them all?
No! No. I deemed it wiser to keep them alive. Considering that there are people who are willing to fight and risk dying for all of you, it seemed like you might have been friends. At least a little. So, you can either try to fight and kill me and probably succeed, but I swear I will bring one or two of you with me. Or you can come with me willingly and the lives of your friends will be spared. Or they can just continue being tortured.
I'll start I'll start translating quietly.
If you would like, I can turn around and walk away right now. But I will come with more men and I will hunt you down. And I assure you, your friends will suffer.
Don't.
Suffer greatly.
Don't.
Wait. Weren't there 10 of you?
No.
No. Roll a deception.
That's persuasion. Oh, nope, that's actually a stat. Damn it.
Yeah.
I have
deception good, bluff.
I have good persuasion, but... oh, thank the stars. 14!
14?
Wow.
That was my pinky. Yeah. I'm good. Done worse. It was any other finger that hurt.
You're just kind of... where are they?
What will you do if we tell you?
What do you think?
That's not the bargain on the table. I have told you why I have come here.
Well, we don't know where they went.
Yeah, unfortunately, when we were attempting to get away, we got separated at the beginning. Yeah, it was difficult to see
dispute
the ran.
I don't care anymore.
Happen, and we thought something else should happen. For all we know, they're eaten by wolves.
Maybe. There are quite a few wolves out there.
Yeah, we've heard them.
Never know when one's going to show up right at your doorstep.
Visible
discomfort. There's a howl in the distance.
Are those your wolves?
No. Wow. Some wild wolves around here. They can be quite vicious.
I'll say in whispering, after I was translating some stuff, saying I only saw three of them. But
what is your choice?
I know it's a bit late, but can I see if he was serious about the others being alive?
Sure.
Okay.
You're pretty alright.
Oh, I thought those were sixes.
I can't sync right now.
Okay. Well, it's both of us, you know.
It's 12 plus. Okay, so 17.
As far as you can tell.
Okay.
Oh, it must have been.
But I mean, it doesn't seem like he's trying to hold back any lies. He seems very relaxed.
I mean, I'm scared right now. I kind of want to just book it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also scared, but for a different reason.
Very well.
I'll start edging away.
He'll turn around. I guess we will head back then. I will grab more forces, and your friends will be destroyed. And he will walk off.
Wait.
He'll stop.
I'll go with you.
It's either all or none.
I'm gonna say this.
Either you all come with me.
I'm gonna say this not. In our language.
Saxon?
Yes, Saxon.
Yes.
English.
In our language, Portuguese.
Yeah.
Es español. En español.
Donde está la biblioteca? I can't prove it. I can't prove it, but I'm pretty sure he's lying. I don't think they're alive.
Sophie says, "We left knowing that they would probably die. We were okay with that."
I wasn't.
What difference does it make now?
Ready to run away, and like I said, it seems like he's lying.
What if he's not? And what if he finds the
then
others?
Then we die too.
What if he finds the others?
Then they die.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't seem like he's buying time. Would you like me to roll?
I don't know how are you wanting to figure that out.
Like, if he's...
Body language.
How would I figure that out?
Yeah.
Like, he's totally okay waiting for us, figuring this out right in front of him. I don't know.
I mean, he was literally just about to leave, because you guys... He seemed like he was done waiting for you guys to make a decision. A second ago. Now you guys are having your little huddle. Seems impatient a little, I mean, I guess.
We need to leave. If they are alive, they probably won't be full.
They were willing to fight for us. I don't feel right.
If we go back, what was the point?
What do you think?
His
orders were to kill.
Since we ran away.
What an innocent girl, isn't she? Katla. I wonder for how long.
Up running, and other people suffer for us. Didn't really want to leave then.
Right now, we have to think about ourselves. What good will happen if we all go with him and die?
Don't see anyone around us, like hiding in our tree line.
We need to think about ourselves before we can do anything for anyone else.
Let's say those.
How are we supposed to help anyone if we just go with him to our deaths?
With the torch, they may be behind us.
Vithir and those people risk their lives on us, for us, so that we can do something for him. We need to do that, right? Or what was the point of them staying behind?
Found us this time. What makes you think he's not going to be able to find us again? How long can we just keep running?
What if we don't let it? As long as we have to.
We need to act.
I'm gonna look around again. I know it's difficult because of the torchlight, but I'm gonna look around again to see if the other or anyone is surrounding us.
But yeah, I wanted to do that too. Look around in the tree.
All right, go for it. Night vision.
22.
You don't see anyone.
Same? Me? Same?
Yeah.
Okay.
Night vision, date.
Even with the night vision, you don't see anyone. I'll see you in a few days. And he will turn around.
Is he going to roll to see if he's serious about that?
He's serious about that.
Okay. I mean, I don't know. He could be saying, like, some bullshit to make us feel safe for a second.
Ned is lying to you. Why would he want you to not... or
guide and roll it.
Want you to roll.
Well, I mean, now you just gave me the answer.
You do. And did I?
Yeah. Maybe he's lying to you to tell you not to roll so that you don't figure out his plans.
That's Josh. Dumb, and I dislike that.
Josh, I've done it to people before.
Never trust me.
16.
Yeah, why would you ever trust him?
17? 16? Yeah. He'll probably see you in a few days. I mean, he might see you sooner than then. He might see you later than then. But he'll probably see you in a few days.
So essentially, I believe he's giving up the hunt till he has more people.
That is entirely up to you, dude. It's a possibility. That is seemingly what he is putting forward, is his intent.
Okay.
Like he said, he's gonna go get more men and come after you.
once he is gone, and the torch is kind of gone.
Oh, before he's completely gone, as he's walking away, he'll pause first. I think we'll start with the one that risked his life most for you.
Has he turned away?
Yeah, and then he'll walk fully into the darkness.
Which I was a fighting
I'm gonna give chase.
Like, once the... Hold on.
It's not a rock.
Are you gonna let him saying hold on stop you?
I don't know if he's actually saying it.
I'm not saying it. But I'm going to first.
You can find a rock.
So as he was saying that, I pick up a rock.
But I'm going to first take another good look around now that the torchlight is gone.
Marksman. I know what you're doing.
To see if there's anyone nearby.
Go for it.
Ah!
I'm gonna give chase and try to
stab him. Hold on! As he's leaving, I have
things happening all at the same time, okay?
Don't touch them! And throw a rock at his head with a...
I'll kind of like glance off the side of his head and...
Oh, you nicked him with health damage.
I will personally. And then he continues on.
Once again, I am saying, I am giving chase. Don't tell me to hold on, she's running!
Does anyone try to stop her as she starts running after him?
Yes!
What do you do to try to stop
her? Grab her.
Roll me a... fighting.
Dang it.
You have to beat her passive, athletic.
I rolled a 9.
That fails. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. My passive athletics is times 4, right? It's a 12.
It's times 3, I think, isn't it?
It's times 4.
Times 4.
Oh, it's times 4, yeah, I failed.
That's a 12 right there.
Yep. So, you run up to him. He's still walking with his back turned.
Can my awareness roll do anything for me now that the torchlight is gone?
The torchlight's still there unless you put it out yourself.
Oh, yeah, I'll put it out.
Okay. What you can see, because you have your dark vision thing to help, is you see him walking away.
He's looking, so like this is faster than you running out of
him. He's walking away, and in front of him are about by 15 or so feet are two more people.
Like around and behind us.
Around and behind, nothing.
Okay.
All right. So you run up to him.
I'm still holding my spear.
I'll pull out my bow.
Gonna try and stab him.
All right, go for it.
I've chosen violence. Son of a bitch.
It's okay, he hit him with a rock with like 13.
I'm gonna grab my bow.
Even better.
And
that's an 11.
Try to stealthily move around from
okay.
where we were.
Let me still.
That's an 11.
An 11?
Mm-hmm.
It will ping into his chainmail in his back and will not
pierce
through it.
Does she get like a bonus thing because he's turned away?
Oh yeah, attacking from the back. That
I
is
mean,
a rule.
Technically, yeah, I guess roll a test, roll with an extra test die.
Should I re-roll or just roll
no,
that?
No, just roll
one
more.
One more.
And add it.
That's a 13.
13. Okay. As it just hits into his armor, and he will whip around and kick at your feet.
Fuck. I am not immune to falling.
You just got all that balance.
It doesn't help with that.
It doesn't help, though.
It's passive agility.
You will fall onto your back and... he will then stick his foot onto your neck and push down just a little bit, and then he will say, if you try to fight me, you will choose for all of them death, and we will cut you down.
Am I able to speak with the... With
yeah,
the
he's not there? Pushing down enough to keep you from speaking, because he wants you to say something back.
Don't... touch him. Don't touch any of them.
Then convince your friends to come back to town.
How long?
The longer you take, the more that will happen to them. So you better convince them quickly.
But if I go in one of their places, a life for a life?
No. I have set my terms. I do not negotiate. I enforce.
Guess I'll just lay there then.
You'll get around and see him lift up his boot off of her neck and continue walking.
I got a 16 stealth, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna go a bit further ahead, just a little bit. So
there's,
like, if he's walking
walk
this way,
further.
I'm gonna be like over here, walking. Like, if he's here and walking in that direction, I'm gonna be like up here.
Mm-hmm. He's making his way south.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay, more like southwest, maybe.
So I'll be like.
How long do you want to shadow them for?
Just a little bit, and then I'm gonna.
Only an hour.
Just like 2 days.
Just a little bit.
We'll be waiting for you. It's okay.
I want to take another extra good look around me. See if there's anyone around or close to me
mm-hmm.
who can like see me or anything. Oh, that's a 12.
No.
Okay.
You seem clear.
And then when he is... about 50 to 60 yards away, and I have a clear shot.
You gonna try to shoot him?
Oh, no.
Alright.
Range on bows is 100, so...
Yeah. Roll the hit. Get an extra test die.
Bonus action aim.
Yeah.
Since I don't know he's aiming, I'll come over to you and help you up and be like...
This is, like, after he's gotten... A lot of like,
oh, okay,
a
then yeah,
fair
I can go there to help you up. But like, they're already dead, there's no reason for us to die as well.
So it'll be 19
for what they're dead,
I believe.
Yeah,
he's bluffing.
Do you know how long your night vision is?
For sure.
Pretty sure it's not super far.
I don't even, it says
you
it can just
know
help
what
you.
We're doing here.
Like, I don't have the book.
I had to try something.
You
right
still suffer penalties
survive,
as normal when in darkness.
But going with them,
okay,
it's going to get.
So subtract an additional die. 15.
My job here is to protect the rest of you, and if it meant that I died, then as long as you guys got away.
What's your
fine.
Bow damage times 2?
Which we can get away.
Times 2? Yeah.
He's letting us get away.
6. 6.
Mm-hmm. At what cost? He's just gonna come back.
You'll fire it, and it'll hit his shoulder and kind of break apart, and know, he goes safe.
You know, hear a plink in the distance.
He pauses.
And then as soon as I do that, I'm sprinting back to everybody.
Alright.
Too fast.
As soon as I get back.
It's still dark, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Straight up.
You never got to third watch.
Right through the trees.
Everyone either hide or run. I got to run. I'm gonna run.
Choose one.
Sophie says run. Let's run.
Which way?
She starts picking up what stuff hasn't been picked up.
Well, then I'll follow you on you, because I don't know which way north.
We can't.
After I threw the rock, I just kind of had slumped to my knees. I was just there, crying.
Eric was like standing by you with the knife out, and is now you're down there. He's like standing in front of you. While the guy was there and walking away, and after the guy leaves, he kind of sits down next to you.
We need to
see. Hands shaking with a knife in both hands.
Did you see what weapons those two had? Or did I see what weapons those two had?
No.
We can't all go together. We're too much of a target.
We can either all run, we can split up, we can hide, or we can hide and try and... from the shadows. Decide fast.
I'm gonna run.
Eric says run.
We need to split up and run.
Leave.
We can go in groups of 2.
I right now, assuming he's not lying, we have possibly days, and
if we want, this is the probably only time we have to try and fight him. Because this is the least amount of men he's going to have.
Multiple of us will die.
Unless me and Sophie keep paying him with arrows from a distance in the darkness.
All of our friends will.
Pretty dead.
Eric says we don't know that.
Yes, we do. He had strict orders to kill us. Why would he keep them alive?
To lure us back?
It felt like he was lying. I don't have proof, but it felt like he was lying. I roll deception on that if you want.
yeah. Sure. If you'd like.
19. Because I'm just trying to get people to believe that they've already died.
Eric says, whether they're dead or not, that doesn't mean we should die trying to kill them. There might be a better chance later.
Do you really think there's going to be a better chance? He already said he was going to come back with more men.
We might be able to get to where we're supposed to go before that point.
I heard he shot him with an arrow.
Sophie, like, why didn't her eye... Let's leave. Let's just leave then.
I'm running. I'm already running. I'm gone.
Some random direction.
I'm going the direction we were heading. Like, as we were walking, I'm just... Let's go.
Eric grabs you by the arm. Cedric starts trying to pull you up. We have to run. We have to leave now. Come on, get up. Up. Come on. Kind of gives you a little pound on the cheek. Come on. We have to run. And start booking it. As you guys running in the darkness, sometimes tripping, bumping into things, hearing howls behind you. Maybe those are wolves. Maybe those are the howls of the dog chasing you.
9 for awareness behind us.
But either way, you feel the dread of being hunted as you move as fast as you can through the night. And we're gonna pause there so that we can, I can take the dogs potty and feed them and have some dinner and stuff like that.
Nice.
And I'm gonna stop the recording and resume it when we resume. Huzzah! Until next time.